No.
Okay, no problem. Okay. Tushar, tell me. We already shared.
Basically, WCF web service, if we created, then we can. There is no need like different type of protocol like HTTP folders or
Okay.
TCP.
Okay.
TCP. It will
Yeah.
be executed anywhere.
Correct. Correct. See, I'll tell you one thing. Okay. Recently, which we have implemented in our project, because we are going to implement it. You already heard about the new technology .NET Core. It's a dependent technology. Please mute it. Otherwise, I'll mute everyone. See. So when we talk about a service, see in the when we were working on the desktop applications, and I wanted to create a service that would be consumed by other applications. Means ek service maine banaya ek jagah, and that should be consumed by some other clients. But earlier, what happened? Once you create a service, that would be available throughout your intranet, not internet. That service we call as a window service. The best example is Active Directory. Active Directory is installed or configured in a company's environment only that cannot be accessed outside the world. You cannot connect your computer to your office computer. You cannot do it. You cannot connect because when we talk about window services, that means it was physically connected with server and the client. Means if Active Directory is installed in your machine in the company's environment, so your machine, your client should be on the same environment, same network, then you will be able to access it, otherwise you won't. That service we called as a window service. Active Directory, once you install SQL Server, it is also a part of service which is installed in your machine. The same way, when we move to the web services, why? Because the window services will not be accessible outside the boundary, outside your network. Then we move to web services because I wanted to expose my service through onto the Google or onto the cloud or onto the outside the world, outside my network. In that case, we went for web services. So web services is only relying on HTTP protocol. But the window services, if there is a window service and client wants to communicate with that window service, in that case you have to use TCP protocol. But when we talk about web services, it is working on some browser and URLs and all those things. When we talk about browsers, that means it supports only HTTP protocol. So, for example, I wanted to expose my company's information, how many employees are engaged in my company. So, if I wanted to show in my intranet, I can go with the window services. Because when the client wants to communicate with the server, so whatever the data or request or response coming and going from one machine to another machine, the data is sent in form of packets. Packets means you can consider as an envelope. When we talk about window service, in that case, that protocol must be TCP, the first thing. And it is very fast while server and the client is communicating because both the machines are rely on or staying on the same network. So, okay, that's true. One server and the client, it is both are on the same network, same environment, so communication would be faster. And when we talk about TCP protocol, means if a person, client machine, I have created one client machine consider as I created one project. Okay, I clicked on submit. I wanted to send this data to a window service. So data would When the data I clicked on servlet, the data will go to the server in form of binary. It will not go that object in a simple employee object. It will go not go into the wires, because wires only supports binary data. So binary data will be much faster while communicating with the client and server. So if any of the your data is wanted to share to someone in the intranet, so that must be in a binary format. The protocol should be TCP. But if you wanted to expose that service to the world outside your environment, then you have to go with the web services. But web services only work with HTTP protocol. So HTTP, it's nothing but you can say on the cloud. Cloud, it will be available on the cloud. Anybody can access it. But it is slower because internet is involved in this scenario. So if you do not have a specific bandwidth of the internet, so your service will not respond properly. It is only for the web. Okay, now we do have a Windows service, we do have a web services. Now the next picture is, can I create a service which will be working for the Windows, means which will work with the TCP protocol as well as for the HTTP protocol? Because earlier my scenario was I wanted to expose my number of employees. If I wanted to expose in my environment, I will go with the TCP protocol. If I want to expose my number of employees onto the world, or I wanted to show onto the browser, then I need to go with the web services concept. Okay, that's true. But here I have to create two different web services. One would be Windows service, second would be web services. So the WCA, Windows Communication Foundation, is giving a flexibility. Create one service that would be consumed by your TCP protocol. You can expose a service with the endpoint with TCP protocol. You can expose one endpoint for the web to the web outside your network. We have to specify HTTP. Means I don't need to create two different services. Earlier I was creating two. One is a web service, one is Windows service. Now the web WCF services will give you only, will create one service and will expose multiple endpoints. If you wanted to consume that service on the web, expose one endpoint HTTP. If you wanted to consume that service on the intranet, expose TCP protocol. And if you wanted to expose that service for the MSMQ, messaging and queues purpose, in that case, you can just expose an endpoint MSMQ. net.msmq something. This flexibility given by the this WCF. Earlier in the web services, the data will be returned to you, to the client. It'll always be a XML format, or you can say a SOAP format. But in the web, when we talk about WCF or the RESTful service, you can return the data in form of JSON, in form of XML, in form of plain text, which was not provided or given by the web services or the Windows service. The third main important thing is, if you wanted in the web services, if you wanted to secure your web service, in that case, we have to do a lot of codes to make a secure web service. But in WCF, you don't bother about those things. You need to just specify some attributes on top of your service. It will create a security for your web service. It will create authorization, authentication, everything. You don't need to write a lot of codes. This is the WCF services. Okay, let's start. I created this PPT in 2008. I'm going to share you. See. What is .NET at the core level? We do have .NET Framework 2.0, consider as this was 4.5 or 4.0. Okay, same. On top of 2.0 framework, we do have our WPF, Windows Presentation Foundation. I'll share with you so that you can remember the things. If you get a chance to work with the WPF application, so don't go and do lot of researching and all those things. I'll tell you what is WPF. Windows Presentation Foundation. Whatever you did in Windows application, 50% is same as WPF. 50% only I'm saying. But it follows one architecture we call as MVVM. MVVM stands for Model View, View Model. When we will look into the MVC, then you will understand the things. But for now, WPF follows MVVM pattern, MVVM, Model View, View Model pattern. And I'll tell you, you already did it. When we start returning the data, creating a response objects and everything, it was same. I have not given a folder name as view model. I have not given a folder name of a class name as a view model. I just created a class login response. That's it. Nothing else. It was similar to the view model concept. I'll tell you when we start with MVC. Okay. So it follows WPF, follows that MVVM pattern. The next is WCF, Windows Communication Foundation, which we are going to learn. WF, workflows. Workflows, nothing but, for example, take one scenario. You wanted to pull the data from one machine and send it to some different database or different machine. For that purpose, we have to create some workflows. It's nothing but you can consider these are the parts of jobs. Means in my company, we do have 8 people who are working in workflows only. What they are doing actually, they in the both the sites, they will create some classes. And the one class will be responsible for implementing the logics. And the one project, one class is responsible for getting the data from somewhere. For example, in my database on daily basis, somebody is registering in the machine, in the database. Somebody has enrolled, somebody has signed up to the applications. On next day, whoever the person joined my application, whoever the person logged in or signed up in my application, I wanted to export that data in some different database for processing. For example, in the credit cards, okay, or in the banks, banking sector, you got a credit card and daily you are getting a call from the customer care. We are providing some services. Services means, if you spend around 20,000 in a month, we will provide you this facility. If you pay 1,000 more extra, we will give you this much reward points. If you wanted to, like, I purchased, recently I got a driving license from RTO, okay? Somehow I missed my driving license in some area. Might be some other person can take an advantage for that driving license. He can do some crimes over there. True, they can do it. If you lost your Aadhaar card, they can take your Aadhaar card and they will use it in a different way for any crime. They can do it. And you will be only the responsible for those things. So there is one company coming here. He tells, give me your Aadhaar card number to me and pay me $1,000. I'll take care of your everything. If you lost your card, just call me. I'll take the responsibility. If you lost your credit card, call to the customer care. If anything happens after your call, after you call to the customer care, I lost my credit card. Anything happened after that call, every burden taken by that company, taken by that bank only, the credit card team only. So they are offering you some services. So that service is, once the person enrolled in the system, I wanted to process that data and passes to some different servers for services, for enrolling services, associating services. So they have to create some workflows. that is called WF. Card space is nothing but when we talk about the mobile devices, okay, you have an option for card space, okay, for the whenever you are going for the mobile devices, jobs and all those things, but it's not required anymore right now. Nobody is using and focusing on those sectors because we do have a different space right now. Xamarin, we have, they are giving a flexibility to develop using a card space. You don't need to go for learning card space anymore. There's no use because I told you that this particular PPT was created at 2008. So that's why I mentioned 2.0. Okay. It's clear now, till now. Any doubt? Please tell me. Suresh. Any doubt, any confusion? Or Akshay?
No.
Okay. Great. Okay. Let's proceed. Okay, Suresh. Okay. So, next. See, once you understood this PPT, I'll tell you, you will be master on that. You don't need to go. You can search the code from the Google and you can implement it. You don't go to learn the concept once again, how it works. Now, see the scenario here. Mobile employees, there are some mobile employees, there are some customers, okay? Company A, there is a company B, customers and mobile employees. One company has a server, company B has a server. Just consider the mobile customer, the customers who is taking an, like who is enrolling the service, who is signing up in your application, and you capture, or by using a desktop machine or by using a mobile device, anything, you sign up in a particular server. Now this server wanted to communicate with different server which has some different logics or implementation. Means this, suppose that this is a client window, this is the server window. If the client and server wants to communicate with each other, then you have to go with the WCSO. What we hear from you? How do I build service-oriented systems? Any idea about SOA? Have you heard this word till now? SOA, S-O-A.
Anything? Service-oriented architecture.
Yes. Service-oriented architecture means, see, whether we talk about Windows service, whether you talk about Spring, whether we talk about what we call web services or WCS or RESTful services, everything is coming in one umbrella. That one umbrella we called as a SOA, service oriented architecture. If you wanted to expose a service, you have to follow the guidelines of the SOA. Service oriented architecture means you are going to design a class which will communicate outside the world, which is going outside your boundary, outside your network, that we call the SOA, service-oriented architecture, service-based systems. How can I send a message securely and reliably? That's true. How can I send my messages or data in safe mode? How do I build a dynamic decoupled applications? Dynamic data we are talking about. Our next generation platform distributed system. If you remember, you are using a VPN. That means VPN is, it is on a different location and you are connecting your here from, I am connecting my VPN machine. It is in US and I am connecting from Pune or from India. That we call as a part of distributed system. Okay, we'll go in depth of distributed system for now. Distributed system means there is one machine which is having a SQL server and rest of the peoples have the clients, SQL clients. They don't have SQL server, they have a SQL client. From there, they are writing the queries. But actually the query is getting executed on the server where the SQL server has been installed. So one service, distributed systems, one SQL server has exposed one service, which was using by some other number of SQL clients, means a distributed system. Got it? A set of extension of the Microsoft .NET framework, that's true. Everything is in top of 2.0 framework. Build WCF using a 2015 and all those things. Okay. VB, Visual C Sharp. Microsoft Windows Vista, it will work on that XP Windows Server, part of .NET 3.0. Three things which you need to understand. If somebody will ask you, what is WCF? You have to give three answers. Is built for unification, interoperability, and service-oriented development. Means unifications means unifies today distributed technologies. The best example for SQL Server. Create a service, deployed in server, and on the rest of the machines, they will have only the SQL client. Means you exposes a service as a distributed so that the different clients can communicate with that service. That's a distributed unification. Interoperability, it's nothing but you have created a service in the by using a .NET or the C Sharp that can be interop by some other platforms, means PHP or you can say Java or some other technologies. They can interop it. Broad support for web services. See, I was talking about you the security systems in the web services. If you wanted to make your service as a secure, when we talk about legacy web services, we called as a WS star. WS star means web service enhancement. Because earlier everybody, you will find only the web services concept, that's it. And the, for the security purpose, they will deploy that service with SSL certificate. That's it, nothing else. But if you wanted to make a service as a secure, not only the transport layer, you know, transport layer means transport layer, nothing but a client and server wanted to communicate. So whatever the medium they are using, that's a transport. If I'm developing a Windows service, the transport would be TCP. If I'm developing a web service and client is going to use our web service, okay, which is available on the web, they are using a transport, means HTTP protocol. So that is interoperability. Means any other applications or any Microsoft technology, they can consume it. So as service-oriented development enables a development loosely coupled services, config-based communication. I don't bother about how would I make a web service as a secure. What are the endpoints? Endpoints, but you can consider in a layman language, URL. I created this service and I exposed one URL to the client. So they can add a reference and they can start doing it or accessing it. Config-based communication means whatever the attributes you are going to set, just open your web config, set your bindings, set your protocols, set your securities. Everything is managed only into the web config. You don't need to go and write the code in the C hash or the VB language. It's on config based. See, service communication, how the service is communicating. Caller is nothing but a client and service is a server side. Caller means I am a client, you guys are the servers. Consider that one. If I am going to log in, if I am going to send the data to the server, the data will sent in envelope format. In the envelope, we do have header, footer, body, right? And every data, whatever the data is getting transferred from one machine to another machine, means a client sends a data to the server. The data will go in form of packets. We called as a messages. Services, we used to say packets, we used to say envelope. Here in the WCA, whatever the data you are going to share, whatever the data you are going to send to the server or the service, that data in a message format. means data getting transferred from one machine to another machine in form of messages only. And the client will also get the data in form of messages. Now, look at WCA, what happens? Clients, now, the client is sending the data to the server. So server means a service has to expose one endpoint to you. The client and server always be communicate with each other by using some endpoints. Endpoints in layman language, one URL. You have to specify some endpoints, port number, whatever, where the service is being hosted. So, and the service has exposed one endpoint and clients also had the same endpoint so that they can communicate with each other. The data is getting transferred in the form of messages. Endpoint is there. Now, the most important thing in the WCF, if somebody will ask, what is WCF? In single line, I can say WCF is a service which includes all legacy technologies. Legacy means Windows service. Legacy means web services. And some other things. The second thing is in WCF. WCF is nothing but a address binding and contract. Address means where your service is being hosted, where you have exposed endpoint. Binding means how you are going to use that service, on which protocol you have used it, means binding. Means binding means a TCP or HTTP. These are the protocols. Address, where the service is being hosted. Bindings, what type of binding you have used it to expose the endpoint. If you wanted to simple web service type of service in the WCF, you have to go with the basic HTTP binding. We do have 9 types of binding in WCF, but mainly only 2 bindings is sufficient, 2 or 3. If somebody is wanting to go with the MSMQ, then we'll have one more binding. Okay, like there. So binding is nothing but a how, means see where the service is being hosted, binding, how it was binded. It's nothing but what type of binding you have used it. Whether it is a basic HTTP binding, whether it is a WS HTTP binding, whether it is a dual HTTP binding. So it depends on the requirement. If you want a simple web service, simple binding, go with a basic HTTP binding. If you want a one level security, go with WS HTTP binding. If you wanted to go with some message based or database security, whatever the data you are going to sharing to the client or client is sharing to the server, data would be secure. So in that case, we have to go with some other HTTP binding. We have 9 types of binding. Contract. Contract is nothing but, you can say, a contract. In a technology term, I can say an interface. Contract means what? What type of data you are going to expose to the client? What type of data? Hello? Yeah, Kiran. Yeah, tell me. Can we talk after 10:30? Because I'm taking one session. Okay. Just give me 1 hour. Okay. Yeah, thank you. Okay, sorry. So contract means what type of data you are going to expose. The client and server always be communicate with the interfaces. That's it. That's a contract. In simple words, contract means what type of data you are going to expose, what type of data the client is going to send it to you. And that communication is nothing but happening with the interfaces only. So there are three things in the WCF. The most important thing which you need to consider while developing the service, ABC. We call as a ABC. Address binding contract. Address means where you deployed your web service. Binding means what binding you have used, what protocol you have used, and the contract means what type of data you are going to accept it or expose it. That's called ABC. In the service side, we do have a concept called metadata. If you remember, anybody has consumed the web services. So once you add the web service reference in your machine, in your project, you will get some WSDL. Web service descriptive language. Nothing but a metadata of your service. Metadata, nothing but a information about the classes. Information about the service, we call as metadata. Now, we are going to the, again, 3 points unifications. See, unified. What is unified? Unified programming model. Earlier, we were using or we were developing a service we called as an ASMX, Active Server. Powerful, extensible, Active Servers, something. Okay, ASMX web services. Interop with other platforms means ASMX web service can be consumed by any platform, any technology. Attribute based programming means once you have set, I'll tell you attribute, that's a part of MVC. They have like implemented those things, attribute based routing and attribute based methods in the classes. Attribute based programming they have implemented. If you wanted to create a service which is based on the attribute. Attribute nothing but a square bracket specify your route name. So that is nothing but a enterprise services they are using. Web service star. Web service star. Star means enhancements. The web service enhancement. You wanted to go for that, you have to use it. Message oriented programming. If you talk about messages and queues, you have to create one service. When we were talking about the Windows services, it's nothing but a .NET remoting concept. So see, earlier we do have four types of services. You have to create, if you wanted to expose a service, you should go with the ASMX. If you wanted to create a service attribute based for the enterprise services, like SAP applications like that, go with this service. Web service enhancement, you have to do a lot of codes for that. If you wanted to create a messages related services, go with this service. If you wanted to create a Windows service, go with this thing. Now the WCF includes everything. Just create one service, which will work for the work like ASMX, attribute, web service enhancement, MSMQ, and the .NET remoting. This is called unified. In simple words, it is built on top of all the legacy technologies, whatever you have. Whether .NET remoting, whether ASMX, attribute based or messages and queues. Productivity, see what it helps actually. See, I have not modified for 2003. Earlier in the web services, we have to write this much of code. See, 20,379 lines of securities, we have to write it, then we'll get a service as secure. These total lines 56,000, for example, in the web services. Now, when we talk about web services enhancement, see, it little bit reduced in web service enhancement. Earlier we were using this way. Now we move to web service enhancement. Lines of code is getting reduced day by day. Now coming to the web services, see, for security, you have to line only one line. The first line, attribute, service contract, secure channel, secure mode equal to Windows. I got a security now. If I wanted to go for reliable messaging, means I wanted to, whatever the data I'm going to send it or receiving it should be reliable. I need to write only one line of code. That we call exactly once guarantees in order something. Reliability. We have to specify it. One line only. And don't bother about the other thing. For the transactions, just specify service operation transaction flow allowed equals to true. Just set one attribute. on the method for the transactions. So whatever the, see, I wanted to implement security. I want a data should be reliable, message should be reliable, and it should be a transactional. I have to write, only three lines of code in the WCF. So whatever we were doing in the web service enhancement and in the web services, we should not go with that. Now WCF takes a responsibility for managing each and everything. Interoperability means it can be interop on any other platform, any other technology, different platforms, true. That service can be consumed by some different platforms, Linux, Unix, Macintosh, whatever, Solaris. Languages, Java can also consume my service. Even the companies, I cannot say like Microsoft only going to use this particular service. Some other companies can also use it, Oracle or some other companies. Because I just need to expose a service, that's it. Different versions, that's true. Whenever you are creating a service and deploying it, you can maintain the versions of the services. Okay, in depth. Investment protection, if you talk about side by side,